Hello, dear people. Welcome to this video special regarding both new arrivals in the GECO Express series. I'm standing here together with Gunnar. Hello, Gunnar.
Hello, Maritz.
We are talking about the two new loads, 6.5 by 55 and 6.5 Creedmoor.
Correct.
And why I think they are particularly successful, we'll talk about after this introduction. When I hear about GECO, then I inevitably think of a use in a sporting context. But you're also firmly rooted in the hunting application with the GECO Express series. Today we're talking about the 6.5 by 55 and 6.5 Creedmoor. The internet is full of discussions about the 308 compared to 30-06 or against 6.5. Please just refresh us here. What does the GECO Express actually do, and how does the 6.5 perform in this field?
In principle, the 6.5 calibers have the advantage that they really have a very balanced loading function. This means that I have a relatively low recoil, a well-flat trajectory, although still sufficient power, to be able to hunt properly for Central European game. The GECO Express distinguishes itself with its soft front side. The soft front side ensures the effect we need in these cases, but we also have a predefined remaining part, and therefore a really safe exit wound.
It's not only the sport shooters who know this now, that this is a great shaped cartridge for the long-range sector, that it delivers high instant impact because it is a hunting bullet, we also know that now. But how does it look when the game is not 150 to 200 meters away, but considerably closer?
The advantage of the 6.5, in combination with the Express bullet, is that I also do not need an aiming point breakpoint correction, even at different distances, one important subject here, because I have very little bullet drop. But also at short shooting distance, the bullet still has a good effect, and still provides a safe exit wound. That means I have a good effect in performance from short shot distance to long shot distance.
For the people who might not already know it straight off the cuff, please enlighten us once more. Why is the small variance in the point of aim here already very conductive during hunting?
When one is hunting, then it is beneficial. When I don't think so much about distance, because sometimes you don't have so much time to think. And I can't see whether it's 127 or 167 meters. And if I had to correct the point of aim in between, that simply costs me time and thought. And when I don't have to spend too much time thinking, don't have to concentrate on the laser, don't spend time clicking, then I'll hit the target safer and make the kill.
How did you proceed in general? This was originally just a cartridge, which was designed for the sporting sector. When you wanted to design such a caliber for the hunting sector now, then how do you approach the development? Do you orient yourselves very much on sport, or do you actually start all over again? What is the procedure?
We have a specified framework. That is, we already know how which bullet parameters function in which in length and in diameter, of course. But of course, we also look at this through the eyes of a hunter. That means that we look at what we need for the hunt. And how can we combine the advantages of this sporty, very precise cartridge with what we require for hunting? And basically, at the end of the day, that we end up with a hunting bullet in the concept, and that this is also developed at the end of the day.
When we look at the 6.5, then there are currently extremely many reloaders on the market, and one has the feeling it's just one of those subjects. It's really fun. You just sit at the workbench in the evening and load your cartridges. What is the challenge for you as a manufacturer in this area to develop such a caliber compared to the challenges involved with perhaps the reloader located on the workbench? What can he do better? What can you maybe do better?
Of course, we have to make sure that the 6.5 bullet, which we see here as an example, doesn't just function from the 6.5 by 55, but also probably from the 6.5 Creedmoor coming out of the 6.5 by 57, perhaps,
too. From a platform?
For reloaders, exactly. And, of course, we also have strict guidelines, which we have to follow. Because when, now take the 6.5 by 55 as an example, we shot this one out of the repeating rifle yesterday. Then, of course, we also limited her in seating depth. We must always abide to the pre-requirements by law. We can't seat the bullet any further out or deeper in. This means, in the case, that the challenge here is to develop a bullet which functions safely and reliably from different platforms.
You already mentioned this. I was very lucky yesterday that I was, among other things, shooting the 6.5 Creedmoor. Also saw and learned many other things for both the 6.5 Creedmoor or with the 6.5 calibers in general. I am always thrilled when I notice how little recoil comes onto the shoulder at the end, compared to what can this cartridge actually do. At the end, we shot again with a suppressor on it, and there is really little to mention, I have to say. I actually think this is extremely, by the way, especially in relation to unusual shooting positions.
Very true. I never know where the game might be coming from. That means that there are also situations, as a right-handed shooter, for example, when the game now comes at you from the right-hand side, that I am very twisted and must somehow get the gun to the shoulder. And when I have the gun simply under control, because it has so little recoil, then I have good control. And then I don't end up with the so-called magnum kiss, for one thing.
We all know this one. Get a bullet patch on here.
An additional advantage is that, from this position, I also have better control of the gun, and can also better see the reaction of the game, and get a better overview of the overall situation in the field. That means I just have more overview because the gun doesn't jump out of the target area so much.
Well, the advantages of the 6.5 caliber, great BC, long flat trajectory, little variance in the point of aim, coupled with a high instantaneous effect, because, finally, there is a lot of steam hitting the game's body. All things under consideration, is the 6.5 the hunting cartridge par excellence?
If there was a hunting cartridge par excellence, then selection would be terribly simple. The 6.5x55 and the 6.5 Creedmoor with the Express bullet are certainly a really good and suitable combination, and both really well suited for hunting applications.
Dear folks, there you have it. Today's trending calibers, the 6.5x55 and the 6.5 Creedmoor. Not only popular among sport shooters who currently indulge in the trendy sport of practical precision shooting, no, also on the hunt. The 6.5 Creedmoor and the 6.5x55 remain highly relevant here. Why this has already been explained for you by Gunnar in this video. Gunnar, thank you very much for your time.
Moritz, always a pleasure.
Thank you very much for your time behind the scenes, and please do what one does on YouTube, subscribe to this channel, press the bell, and otherwise, stay safe and take care.